Yeah, hello and welcome to another update video about Render. Render did push a little higher after my last video and might currently just be retesting the previous trend line. Yeah, we had this trend line of this trend channel in which Render has been moving till it had a bit of a fake out to the downside. So it moved back up. It might just be retesting this trend line and flipping resistance for support, which would be good. There are still two wave counts here on this chart. There's no change to the outlook, but we can formulate a support area that now needs to hold for Render to push higher. In my first wave count, and this indicates why Render is a bit of a nebulous chart. It's a little bit unclear. Yes, it's an uptrend, but it's very choppy. Okay, so it's a very choppy trend. It's not like impulsive or anything. At least it would be hard to justify an impulse. So in the primary count here, we have a 1-2. Wave 3 topped in April this year, then a wave 4 down, and the move up here could be a wave 5. So we talk about a wave 1 in a leading diagonal. Okay, so it's a very unclear chart because diagonals are always difficult. They don't really have clear targets. Just be aware of that when you trade it. Expect headwinds and so on. Yeah, it's not an impulsive chart. Nevertheless, it is one of the charts that performs quite well at the moment. Yeah, we came down, briefly broke out of the channel. Usually when you have a diagonal, you don't want the price to break out of the channel. Now, okay, we give it a chance because it did hold the previous swing low of the 10th of May and it recovered and it's back in the channel. So if this count is correct, and there is, I mean, it's not high confidence, right? Because we're not dealing with an impulse, but we, you know, it's tradable as long as it holds. So it did hold that swing low here so far. And as long as we hold above 171, the focus can be on higher. And we're looking at targets around $3. Yeah, that would be... Because if you know, if you look at this and we talk about, okay, this could be the fifth wave would unfold as an ABC structure because we talk about the diagonal, then we're looking at target wise, yeah, measuring the length of the A wave going to the low of the B wave, and the target for the C wave would be around $3 at the minimum, the 1-to-1 ratio, and it would need to go above the A wave high anyway. So that's sort of what we're looking at, but it needs to hold 171. And again, it's hard to say, okay, what is this? This could be a first wave, yeah, of the C wave, possibly, or just the first wave of the first wave. Either way, it's not impulsive, but it could again be a diagonal. Nevertheless, it seems to be doing a pullback. Because it's doing a pullback, we can formulate support. So we can be looking for the 78.6 retracement. So let me make that a bit larger. So it already reacted here to the area between the 38.2 and the 50% retracement at 191. But ideally, we want to see wave 2 support hold. Yeah, I mean, it doesn't necessarily need to go down that low, right? But the thing is, it needs to hold the 78.6 retracement. Breaking below that will be a sign that things aren't going to hold. So we've got the 179 level. Okay, so this is the support area that needs to hold for price to go higher. Any break below 179 will make it very likely that it's going to break below 171. So hopefully that's clear. That should allow price to go higher from there as long as support is holding. But it's not a very, very clear chart. At the moment, yeah, you could argue, you know, it's back in an uptrend. But if it breaks below 179, what happens then? Well, then we would be in favor of the alternative count, which would allow for a much deeper pullback into the region between 77 cents and 130. In that count, as explained in a previous video, we have a 1-2 setup, and this is a B wave top. Yeah. So in that count, it's a bit slow our internet, but there you go. We'd say this was a wave 1, the move up into February, then an A wave down in 3 waves, an overshooting B wave, very choppy, overshooting B wave. Yeah. Didn't overshoot any target, so it was fine. Yeah. It's a valid overshooting B wave, also very choppy, and then this is now a C wave down, which could get one more low into the region between 130, or another support level is $1.08 and 77 cents. This is a 1-2 setup, and then it could rally higher from there. This is also a valid interpretation. These are my two views about Render. Only below 77 cents this will turn into something really bearish. So I hope you liked the update. If you did, please hit the like button, leave a comment and subscribe. And if you really like the content, then please check out the channel membership. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye bye. Thank you.